I am Barbara Sutton, Director of Ministerial Formation and Field Education here at St. John's School of Theology and Seminary. In addition to these responsibilities this semester, I am teaching the course Ministry on the Margins with an emphasis on accompaniment and encounter. The way we minister has changed dramatically these past weeks. The pandemic is disorienting, and the margins suddenly seem closer to me. How did this virus creep into our homes and past our watchful eye? My life has been disrupted, as has yours, most likely. Even backup plans seem unreliable. Days of Advent waiting seem simple by today's measure. Illuminated here in the St. John's Bible is the parable, Dinner at the Pharisee's House. It is an encounter between an unnamed woman, Jesus, and Simon. Central to this illuminated encounter is the HIV virus in the Petri dish. It is just beyond the solid gold and blue bar, reminiscent of the creation illumination in Genesis. While HIV is not the novel coronavirus, there are similarities. No one was immune. It was everyone's disease then, as is the coronavirus now. They are individual diseases, yet they demand a communal response. We see the unnamed woman dressed in colorful, vibrant fabrics. She is alone and seems to want to be seen, brokenness and all. She has brought chaos into the house. Even a good person like Simon distances. And he disrupts Jesus with this question, as if testing him. And when Jesus is disrupted, he turns to love as a place to stand. Let us stand with the unnamed woman for a moment. Fix your gaze. How do you see her? As an objectified person with no name, who is merely a statistic, one more infected person who raises my anxiety, or one who has shown great love? She is my sister, and she is my neighbor. She is one who lives on the margin. She is you, and she is me. And less than 6 feet away is a gold Petri dish holding the HIV virus. She could have fixated on the virus, or on Simon, who dismisses her. But she chooses to anoint the feet of Jesus with extravagant love. These days are surreal, where every doorknob is suspicious and every touch rejected. The world so needs the sacrament of anointing, and yet touch seems forbidden. How will we touch one another and be a sacrament of healing? Perhaps we could exchange hugs for voices of compassion, saying, "That really touched me," or, "I really appreciate what you do." We can also hold heart space for people dropping to the floor in tears and longing for healing. And like a Petri dish, we can create a life-giving culture and be co-creators with God, letting people know we see them and hear them. We can validate their fears and stand in the place of love. God bless and be well.